Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. I promise this right here is going to be the last checking for the radius of convergence video for now. So I'm not planning on doing any more of those. I wanted to talk about this one right here because it's not a special case, but it's probably the first time we're ever going to encounter that you have to check for the boundary points if this thing still converges. Okay. What do we want to do? Well, first we have to decide for a little convergence test. Convergence test, that's the word. So let's say those are our sequences, a case. And once again, I'm going to decide for the ratio test because it works out the best. Okay, we are going to have the limit as k approaches infinity of absolute value of a k plus 1 over a k. And if this thing is strictly less than 1, well then, that series converges absolutely. Okay, here we go. I'm going to refer to this limit as just capital L. Absolute value of, okay, just plug the k plus 1 into everything here. So we're going to get negative 1 to the k plus 2th power k plus 2th x to the k plus 1th power over k plus 1. A big over a complex fraction we're going to get now a k. So negative 1 to the k plus 1th power x to the k power over k. A lot of stuff is going to cancel out. The absolute value is multiplicative, meaning absolute value of a times b is the same as absolute value of a times absolute value of b, meaning we can just distribute this absolute value into the negative ones. Absolute value of negative 1 is just 1. So let's get rid of this chunk right here. Also, x to the kth power and x to the kth power is going to cancel out. We are going to get the limit as k approaches infinity of, okay, now we only have x to the first power up here. So let's use the multiplicative property of the absolute value to break this up into the absolute value of x times the absolute value of, taking the reciprocal, k over k plus 1. If you don't know where this property right here comes from, just take a look at Papa Flammy's advent calendar. I made a little proof on that. K is element of natural numbers, so that ain't negative, never. So there won't be ever negative, so absolute value of something non-negative is just the thing itself. And if we take the limit as k approaches infinity, well, we can just factor out the k on both terms right here. So this makes k over k, this is just 1 plus 1 over k. This and that is going to cancel out, so we are going to have the limit of the absolute value of x, 1 over 1 plus 1 over k. We can just distribute the limit into everything. Limit of a constant is just a constant. Also, limit of 1 over k as k approaches infinity is just 0. So this overall is nothing but 1. Meaning, we're going to end up with the absolute value of x, which you want to be strictly less than 1. This one now is our radius of convergence. But not completely. That's where the special case comes in, you could say. For all those other sequences I had, for those other series, we had the property that our radius of convergence is basically infinite. So you can't really check for the boundaries of a function where the radius of convergence is infinite. It really doesn't make much sense. There are no boundary points in this interval. Also, we had a geometric series, but there was the thing, if you sum up infinitely many ones or negative ones, it's just going to diverge into infinity or nowhere at all. Okay. But here, how is it about 1 and negative 1? Because absolute value of x, strictly less than 1, is equivalent to saying that our x is between negative 1 and 1. So we have to check for our boundary points if our series actually converges or not. Let's plug negative 1 in and see what we get at first. So, ln of, okay, I'm not going to put it like this. We are going to write this out. Okay, we are going to have the sum from k equals to 1 to infinity of, okay, negative 1 to the k plus 1 power, negative 1 to the k power over k. This makes negative 1 to the 2k plus 1 power. Negative 1 to some even power is just 1. So this makes negative the sum running from k equals to 1 to infinity of 1 over k. And the bad thing is, this thing right here is the harmonic series, so this thing is going to converge. Not. it's going to diverge. I'm terribly sorry. It's going to diverge. It's going to go to infinity because you are summing up more and more parts which don't become any smaller, not really smaller in the grand scheme of things. So this thing is going to diverge. There's nothing but negative the harmonic sequence. I don't know if this has an index or something. Never mind, it's going to go to infinity overall. Okay, so it doesn't diverge, it doesn't converge for negative one. But how about positive one? Now we have the sum from k equals to 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1th power over k in this case. Because 1 to the kth power is nothing but 1. Why not write this out a little bit? Okay, at first we get 1 over 1. Okay, this is just 1. Plus. Okay, this is going to give us negative. So negative 1 to the third power is negative 1 over 2. Positive 1 over 3. And it's going to go on. Negative 1/4. Positive 1/5. Negative 1/6. And so on. Why not turn this into something completely positive? So without those negative signs in between here. So I'm going to leave this first term how it is. It's going to be useful in a minute. But on this term, we are going to have, okay, let's take a look at a more general case. You see, we have 1 over n, you could say, minus 1 over n plus 1. Okay, we can advance those fractions, this by n plus 1 over n plus 1. So we are going to get n plus 1 over n times n plus 1. And then negative n. It's nothing but, okay, this and that is going to cancel out. So this is 1 over n times n plus 1. Okay, meaning overall that we are going to get 1 minus 1 half, those two terms. Then those two are going to be, okay, plus 1 over what? N times n plus 1, so 3 times 4 is nothing but 12. Plus 1 over 30. Plus, okay, this is going to be 7 and 8, it's going to be 56, and so on and so on. Now we can actually do a little approximation now. If we just switch this one, this negative 1 half, and this 1, well, okay, 1 is just 1, that's okay. So this is less or equal to 1. 1/12 is, well, pretty small, but it's even smaller than, 1/4. I hope you agree with me. You can just do a little proof. This holds. Okay, 1/30 is even smaller, but it's even smaller than 1/9, and so on. And the next term is going to be strictly smaller than 1/16, and so on. Meaning, overall, this whole sum is strictly less than negative 1/2 plus 1 plus 1/4 plus 1/9 plus 1/16 plus dot dot dot. We can rewrite this because this is just, so 1 is nothing but 1 over 1. So 1 is 1 squared, 4 is 2 squared, 9 is 3 squared, and so on. We're going to get negative 1/2 plus the sum running from k equals to 1, in this case, to infinity of 1 over k squared. And we have evaluated this useful sum before. This is nothing but negative 1/2 plus pi squared over 6. Not 16, just 6. And you see, we have actually found an upper bound. So this obviously is finite, meaning this is also finite. So we have actually used, in German, it would be the Majorantenkriterium, major criteria, I don't know. Leave in the comments what it's called in English. Yeah, meaning our radius of convergence is actually like this right here on this natural log. And then we are done. Yeah, this is kind of a special case, something you might have encountered before in mathematics when dealing with series. I'm being serious here. It happens sometimes. And yeah, I thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy this video, please like, subscribe, recommend channel. If you like, if you want to support channel a bit more, leave some comments, check out my website, by those teachers I created or whatsoever. And up until the next video, have a flammable day. See ya.